Hello, welcome to the DTOS News Desk. I am Xavier Lages, Head of Projects, Marketing and Communication, and I'm with Madvi, Technical Manager at DTOS. We are very happy to guide you through the major announcements and the major highlights of a budget which has been released last Friday. So Madvi, the least to say is that this budget was an expected one. Following the reveal of the budget, I have heard several critics, but I don't share those critics around this budget. And I think that the measures that have been announced will allow the country to absorb the shock of the pandemic. We can highlight the fact that this budget is focused on social inclusion. This budget has announced major infrastructure investment for Mauritius. Also, a major highlight of the budget is around sustainability, which will bring our island into a new era of green economy. And I think those are very, very good measures. The announcement has been made during the budget of the reopening of the borders, completely as from the 1st of October and partially as from the 15th of July. And I think these measures are very good and will be a great relief for the tourism industry.
I agree with you, Xavier. I will also add the creation of the new industry, which is the medical, pharmaceutical and biotechnology industry, which is here to expand our economy and give up a boost up to our investment as well.
Obviously, one of the main measures in the budget concerned tax. And there were a lot of expectation around taxation for this budget. So maybe you can guide us through the major announcement and the major measures that has been released and announced last Friday.
Indeed, Xavier. In fact, this budget is mostly focused on three O's, which is the revival, recovery and resilience. From a fiscal point of view, it seems to be a no tax budget. This is what everybody's claim, right? Compared to last year, where the contribution sociale généralisée was introduced and the solidarity levy was revisited.
Yeah, right? It's a strong increase last year.
Yeah, I see. Say indeed. With this budget, there has been the introduction of new tax incentives, tax exemption, tax holidays, and tax credit, and this has been provided to boost up the investment, which
so
is one
the
of
the idea is to attract foreign investors to Mauritius.
That's right. Okay. For instance, one of the incentives which has been provided is the introduction of the tax arrears settlement scheme. This has been extended.
Yeah.
So this is a good incentive for taxpayer. Another one which is quite prominent for our industry is the premium visa. So people holding the premium visa will not be taxed on the Mauritius source income.
Yeah.
So long that this income is not remitted in Mauritius.
Yeah.
So this seems to be something very attractive for our
in order to attract people to live in Mauritius for a period of time.
Yeah.
Without being taxed
on the Mauritius source income.
Yeah.
Coupled to the incentives, there is the introduction of 2 rupee levy per litre on more gas and gas oil for the purchase of vaccines. As we know, the COVID-19 is creating havoc in our country and economy, and this will help the purchase of vaccine and to immunize our population as well.
I think that there is also a set of measures absolutely innovative that have been announced around sustainability. And I think we can mention not all of them, but some of them, which will bring Mauritius to the new era of green economy. Obviously, the government wish to increase the penetration of renewable energy to 60% of our country's energy needs. Also, the government has announced the phase out of the dependency on coal energy by the same period. And companies and individuals will be able to sell energy and green and renewable energy to the CEB grid. And I think this is a very good news. And also, obviously, the government has announced a major investment for the preservation of our coastline, Mauritius coastline, and also for a green and depolluted Mauritius. And I think those set of measures are very interesting for the going forward, for the long term and for the future of Mauritius. Malvi, maybe we can switch on an important topic, which has been lengthily discussed and commented last year, which was the inscription of Mauritius on the grey list of the FATF and on the black list of the EU, which obviously is very detrimental to the reputation of Mauritius.
Indeed, Xavier, the government has made a commitment for an early exit of Mauritius from the FATF grey list and also the EU blacklist. So several measures have been announced to be able to have an early exit. One of them is to reinforce the AML safety legislation in order to cater for the FATF recommendations. And also, secondly, there will be the establishment of the Financial Crime Commission, the Mauritius Bill, the Securities Bill. All these will be introduced to be able to reinforce the AML safety and to go in line with FATF recommendation.
So the idea is to bring Mauritius in the highly reputable jurisdiction.
Yeah, in fact, we hope that we have early implementation of these measures. To be able to exit from this list, this is only that we can do is that we implement these measures as soon as possible, so that we can get early from this list. Early is like we expect it to be like end of this year, okay, and by latest beginning of next year. Mm.
Some very interesting measures have been announced around immigration to Mauritius, and some the purpose being to ease the procedures to come and leave to Mauritius. Indeed, the list of qualifying activities has been removed, making it more easy to qualify for an occupation permit. We can also state that the spouse of an occupation permit holder will be allowed to work in Mauritius, and the non-citizen holding an occupation permit as a professional will be able to switch a job without the necessity to submit a new application for his occupation permit. So the global purpose is obviously to attract pool of talents to Mauritius and to make it more easy to immigrate to Mauritius. And maybe you can talk a little bit about the tax incentive.
In fact, there has been an extension of the tax holidays from 5 years to 10 years for family officers, fund managers, asset managers.
Yeah.
And new companies in prescribed sectors like biotech technology, healthcare, innovation, which will be granted an investment certificate where they can benefit from an 8-year tax holiday provided they have registered with the EDB. Further, companies engaged in biotechnology and medical and pharmaceutical sector will be taxed at 3% instead of 15%. And they will also be given a full tax credit on the cost of patents. This is something very interesting for that industry, which is being launched and which we hope that will give a boost up to our economy.
So it's a wrap up on the major highlights of the budget. We'll be producing a more detailed analysis that will be accessible on our social media platforms and on our website, ditos-mu.com. See you next time.